A pleasure. Welcome to One and All. Today we are discussed about the subject of human resource management. Human resource management is nothing but it stands for managing the employees of an organization. So, according to Edwin Plippo define, human resource management is the process of planning, organizing and motivating the employees and controlling of the employees to procurement and provide the development and provide the right compensation of the workers and to end the organizational individuals and societal needs for satisfied. So it is based upon the fulfill of human needs and to enhance the satisfaction level of workers. Human resource management includes all activities used to retain employees and to selection. To select the right man for the right job is the main objectives of the HRM. So the activities involved in HRM like the first one is recruitment and selection of the employees and providing the training to the employees. The third one is performance analysis. To analyze the performance of the workers and final to provide the right compensation for the workers. So to maintain a smooth relationship between the workers and the top level management. It is the activities involved in HRM. Next, the objectives of HRM. So we discussed about the what are the objectives involved in the HRM. The first one is to formulating the efficient strategies towards the employees. The second one is to finding the right man for the right jobs and to next to provide the training to the people. Next to evaluate the performance and to provide the best compensation to the workers and to ensure that quality communication between the top level to the lower level employees. At final to maintaining the correct ethical policies. The next. Now we discussed about the topic of functions of HRM. So what are the functions? The function is divided into two categories. First one, managerial functions, and second one is operative functions. In managerial function, the planning is the number of type of employees needed to accomplish the organizational goals are determined. The next one is organizing. Tasks are allocated among its members. Relationship are identified and activities integrated towards a common objective. Directing means to different levels and making them contribute maximum to the organizational possible. And staffing to allocate the employees. Controlling means to control, planning, organizing and directing the employees and actual performance is checked, verified and compared with the plans. So these are the managerial functions played by the HRM. The next one is operative functions. In operative function, first one, procurement of employees. How to procurement of employees is based upon recruitment and candidates is the function preceding the selection which brings the pool of prospective candidates for the organization so that the management can select the right candidates for the this pool. The second one is development. Development means to analyze the job. It is the process of describing the nature of your job and specifying the human requirements like qualification, skills and work experience to perform that job. The third one is compensation. In compensation is based upon the performance analysis to ensure that the performance of employees is the acceptable level. The fourth one is maintenance. Maintenance means the human resources is considered as an asset for the organization. So, employee turnover is not considered good for the organization. Human resource management always try to keep their best performing employees with an organization. In motivation, it's based upon the employee welfare, that is to various services or benefits facilities to provided by the employees. At final, integration of employees. The next, we discussed about the topic of HRP. So HRP is the human resource planning. Human resource planning means to selecting the right man for the right job at the right place. It is defined as the process of the management determine how an organization should move from the current manpower position and it is decided to based upon the future manpower. HRP is also called manpower planning, personnel planning and employment planning. It is the continuous process of predicting the future workforce. So it is bridging the gap between the supply and the demand for the workers. The next topic is type of HR policies. So what are the policies to be based upon the HRM? First one is originated policies. The originated policies is based to made by the top level management. The next one is appealed policies. Appealed policy, it is the request to handle the certain situation for the employees or top level management. The next one is imposed policies. So imposed is compulsory to the government or the legal authorities to be imposed. The next one is general policies. It is related to the any issues or else any representative or the prior to the top level management. At final, specific policies. So it is based upon the transfer or promotion or recruitment, anything to relate to the specific issues or else to formulating the policies. The next one is steps in human resource planning. There is 4 steps in human resource planning. First one is analyzing the labor supply. So analyzing the labor supply means to identify the company's current human resources or else wanted resources. The second one is forecasting the labor demand, and third one is it is bridging the gap between the demand and the supply of the workers, and fourth one is development and implementing a plan of human resources. So these are the steps involved in a human resource planning. Next one is advantages and disadvantages of HRM. So first one is help in gain a competitive. So it enables a business in hiring skilled and qualified workforce by creating a large pool of competent people. Second one is edge help solve HRM. So HRM management plays a efficient role in retaining skilled employees for a longer term with an organization. It monitors the working environment provided to workers, ensures that the hygienic working place, better remuneration and extra benefits. Third one is problems. So what are the problems? First one is human resource management influences the overall productivity, profitability of the business organization. It is one which monitors the allocation of all resources, ensures that the full utilized with minimum wastage. Fourth one is make the efficient use of employee reduce. So it handles disputes and resolves all queries of the workforce from the time to time. Human resource management lead to smooth functioning of an organization by addressing all problems employees in a better manner. At final, cost help anticipated plan for changes. So it is helps to motivating the employees by way of cost, achieving the desired goals and objectives. Human resource management motivates workforce by rewarding them as per performance, providing welfare facilities. The next one is disadvantages of HRM. So first one is difficulty in predicting the people behavior. So the behavior is based upon the people's, that is very human resource management system requires. In human behavior, there is no uniformity in terms of different people categories at the distinct way. The second one is problems with preceding external events. So the human resource management lacks universal approval academic base due to the recent origin. Organization renaming their workforce department as HRM, which may not yield real result. The third one is needing constantly monitoring. So another major limitation is to inability and predict the external events by way of behavior of people. So HRM needs a full support of all working people or the top level management in an organization for its successful implementation. In absence of proper support from the top management or else any lower management, it may not yield expected result. Final, leading to industrial relation problems. So lack of essential information about the workers adversely affects the performance of human resource management system. These systems require proper database of employees before implementing them. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of HRM. Next one is HR process. So there is 4 process involved in HR. First one is to selecting or to recruiting the people. Second one is to benefit, to giving the pay benefits and the remuneration to the people. Third one is to analysis of performance to performance management. At final, employee relationship between the top level management to the lower level management.